Keep yourself updated. Subscribe to Vedanta and click bell icon.
Hi friends, welcome to this session. In this video, we are going to learn that how to create a drop down list. What is that? A drop down list. Actually, how drop down list look like means, for example, here we are going to create some data. The date is equals to today, open bracket and close bracket and press enter. And here in the place of segment, there is some repeated segments like government, private, enterprises or small business. So when I'm preparing this data in daily basis, it is highly difficult to write the segment name every time. So here I have created a list. So here automatically system is giving a chance to click on the handler. So when you click on the handler, it is giving some list. Okay, segment from government or private, for example, government and the city. And again, there is some repeated cities. So if this is called as actually a drop down list. If the drop down list is created, you can simply select the options from the drop down list. So every time you no need to type the government segment or city of Hyderabad. So drop down list help you to do the work in the easiest and the fastest, right? So here we're going to create a drop down list. And here, this is just an example that which I already created. So here we are in sheet number one. So in the sheet number one, when we are going to create the data, see here we need to enter the date, and here we need to select the segment and the city and the product, the total sales and quarter sales, and here yearly sales. So when you move your cursor to the segment, system should give a list of segments. Again, when you move your cursor to city, system should give a list of cities, right? So every time you don't need to type the text of government or the text of segments or cities, right? So you do one thing, if you want to create a drop down list, if you want to enable drop down list, first we need to list the options. So here I'm going to create some segment list, that is government, and here private, and here enterprises, and again a small business, right? And this for all the segments. Again, here in the next to that, I'm going to create some city names as Hyderabad. And I'm going to create Chennai, Mumbai and Delhi. There is some cities, right? So now you may see that now the address of the cell is E6, and this is E7, E8 and E9. So now we to this list, we should give a name. We should give a range name. So the address of individual cells are E6, E7, E8 and E9. So now simply select the range and click on the name box. Click on where? Click on name box, and it is also known as address box. So click on the name box and type, this is what? Segments. So here what I'm writing here is segments, or you also can enter, for example, segment list, then press enter. So here the individual cell address is E6, E7, E8 and E9, but all together the address of this range is segment list. And here we have the city names. Those are all having G6 and G7, G8, G9 and the G10 cell addresses. So simply select the range of cities and click on the name box and give a name to this range as CI cities list. Then press enter. And here segment list. This is segment list and this is cities list. So here you add somewhere, not in the working sheet, in any other sheet, you create the drop down options list and give a name to the list. Once the drop down range is created and when they are named with any specific name, just remember these names and to attach the ranges to the cells, to the rows or columns. And for example, if you are going to create a table of only in this range, then select this range. Or if you want to apply a drop down list to the whole column, then click on the column header, right? Then press from the keyboard, directly you can press Alt plus D and wait 1 second, and again press only L. I repeat once again, select the small range or the total column, that is your wish, and then press Alt plus D at a time and leave the keyboard, wait for 1 or 2 seconds, then again press L, Alt plus D comma L. And here we would like to allow a list. Allow what? List. Not only in this way, even if you're not able to use the shortcut keys, then you go manually, go to data tab. In the data tab, you can see an option called as data validation. Click on the handler and there you click on again data validation. There you can access the same box. And here we would like to allow a list. And what is the source name? The source name which we already created the ranges. So before giving the source name, you just insert sign equals to segment, segment, list, segment list. Segment list. Then click on OK. Now after entering the date, if you once come to the segment here, you can see the drop down list is available here, right? Yes. Next, we would like to create a drop down list for cities. Then select a small range or the select a whole column and press Alt plus D comma L and go to select list, or else go to data menu, go to data tab and click on data validation handler, select data validation and allow list, and the address of city range is that we already named as citieslist, city list, cities list. Then click on OK. Again here also you can access the range of cities. So every time when you are preparing the data, it is easy to select options from the drop down list. Like when we are creating any data that belongs to states, for example all Indian states or American state, so that is your wish, right? So here it just, we are simply creating list and we're giving a name to the range, and in the wherever you like to get the list, simply we are selecting the whole range and press Alt plus D comma L and go to enter the same. And if you want to remove the drop down list in the same location, simply erase this address. In the place of allow, just keep any value, then click on OK. Whenever you keep any value, you can enter your own value, right? And here the drop down list available here. And if you want to remove drop down list for this column, select it, Alt plus D comma L, and simply in the place of allow list, simply click on any value, then click on OK. Then again the drop down list has been removed. This is how we create drop down list and how we remove a drop down list. Thank you.
Thanks for watching. Keep yourself updated. Subscribe to Vedanta and click bell icon.